Hi and welcome back to my channel. I'm Inka and I have a master's in neuropsychology. Dopamine and serotonin are both neurotransmitters, and they can get a little bit confusing because they share some similarities, but they are completely different neurochemicals. So in this video, I first take a brief overlook on how these neurotransmitters are similar, and then I talk about their differences. But in essence, dopamine and serotonin are kind of like comparing an arm and a leg. They are both limbs and help you move, but you can't do things with the leg that you can do with an arm and vice versa, and you preferably want to have both of them functioning properly in a coordinated fashion. So how are dopamine and serotonin similar? So both dopamine and serotonin are neurotransmitters and neuromodulators and affect cognition, mood, energy, and behaviors. They are also both monoamines, which means that they both contain one amino group connected to an aromatic ring by a two-carbon chain. And now to the differences. So starting with the chemical structure, dopamine is a catecholamine and serotonin is an indoleamine. This means that they have different precursors. Dopamine and catecholamines are made from phenylalanine and tyrosine, and serotonin is made from tryptophan. You get both of these amino acids from the diet in things like protein and banana. Dopamine and serotonin also have different derivatives, which means that they are converted into different things. So dopamine produces noradrenaline and adrenaline, which are hormones that are related to stress states and alertness, whereas serotonin is converted into melatonin, which supports sleep, circadian rhythm, and immunity. Dopamine and serotonin are also associated with slightly different effects on mental state. Dopamine is more about action, drive, motivation. It can make you move and act fast and even be impulsive. Whereas serotonin is mainly linked to behavioral inhibition and calmness. But this is not to be confused with sedation, so serotonin is actually important for the daytime wakefulness and energy. They are also both linked to social behavior, but whereas dopamine is more linked to the motivation and approaching social situations, serotonin is more linked to cooperation and benevolence and agreeableness. Dopamine and serotonin are also both involved in memory and learning processes and are both important in forming memories. Learning and forming memories requires roughly two processes. One is to be able to pay attention to the material and manipulate this in your prefrontal cortex, in your working memory. And the second is to being able to transfer this learned material into the long-term memory. So dopamine is very important for this first stage in which you attend to the information and manipulate it in your working memory, whereas serotonin is very important and linked to the activation of the hippocampus and forming long-term memories from the learned material. The symptoms of high and low levels of these neurotransmitters are also partially different. So low dopamine are shown to lead to lowering of activities, loss of interest, loss of emotion, loss of motivation, loss of focus, even loss of verbal fluency and speech. Disorders linked to low dopamine include things like Parkinson's disease, which is characterized by loss of movement and affect, and also ADHD, which can cause a loss of focus and attention. Low serotonin is more linked to loss of happiness and contentment and calmness, and can lead to feelings of being sad and nervous and irritable and even hostile. It can also reduce sleep quality and consequently reduce daytime wakefulness. Low serotonin can also cause digestive issues and some memory problems. So some conditions that are associated with low serotonin are things like post-traumatic stress, panic disorder, and OCD and anxiety. So what about high levels of dopamine versus high levels of serotonin? As dopamine is important for a drive and action and motivation, high levels of dopamine can make a person very goal-driven and achieving. But when too high, dopamine can make also the person to go into overdrive, being impulsive, and having addictions. It's, for example, associated with binge eating, gambling, alcoholism, and excessive risk-taking. High levels of serotonin helps to maintain happy mood, contentment, and benevolence, but too high serotonin can actually lead to nervousness, nausea, sweating, and heart palpitations, and in extreme cases, even a syndrome called the serotonin syndrome. Next, I'm going to talk about the networks. Dopamine and serotonin work in different networks, although they do overlap. There are four dopaminergic pathways in the brain, which mainly control movement, attention, executive functions, and hormones. Serotonergic projections are pretty widely distributed to all around the cortex. So as I mentioned, the networks partially overlap and affect each other. For example, serotonergic 5-HT2A and C receptors are also expressed throughout the dopaminergic mesolimbic and mesocortical systems. So there are many ways in which these two neurotransmitters actually affect the functioning of each other. Finally, I talk about the speed of production. Serotonin is characteristically a little bit more stable than dopamine. Although dopamine also has this tonic baseline release that is more steady and stable, it can also spike up fast and dip down fast as well. So dopamine can rise a lot more, a lot faster, especially in the presence of some reward cue or dopaminergic stimulation. For example, in one study, they stimulated dopaminergic and serotonergic neurons at the same time, and dopamine rose 300 times more than serotonin, despite the similar tissue content of these two neurotransmitters. However, dopamine also fatigues faster. This means that when the neurons are repeatedly stimulated, this kind of fast release of dopamine kind of loses its effect at some point, but serotonergic neurons will keep releasing serotonin in lower quantities but for longer. So I guess a real life example of this might be that when you drink a cup of coffee, you boost your dopamine, motivation and focus, but drinking coffee all the time will eventually lose its effect. So it's not able to maintain this similar dopamine spike all the time. In comparison, if you are stimulating serotonin turnover, for example with sunlight, often and longer durations, that would end up producing more serotonin. So I hope I've been able to capture some of the similarities and differences between these two neurotransmitters, and I just want to briefly conclude and summarize everything I just said. So as a conclusion, dopamine is a neurotransmitter that's associated with action, motivation, and alertness, whereas serotonin is more associated with contentment, happiness, and calmness. They have different precursors, but you can get both of them in, for example, protein-rich foods and banana. They also have different derivatives, dopamine being more related to this kind of activating stress hormones, and serotonin being more related to sleep hormones. They also work in different networks that partially overlap and modulate each other's functions. Both of them have this kind of slower, more stable release, but dopamine can also be released very fast, and it can spike fast and also dip down fast, especially in response to dopaminergic stimulation. So that's it for this video. If you like these topics, click the subscribe, like, and the bell button to get notified from the future videos. And let me know in the comments, do you feel more maybe dopaminergic or serotonergic? And if you have any questions, I would be happy to answer and address those in the comments and in the future videos.